Yo guys, welcome in this new video. In this video, we will actually start building some cool hobbies. I'll just do 5 maybe each chapter, and we'll make it very detailed, very cool. You can follow my style, but of course make your own if you can. First, what we're gonna do is make the stats data store a different name, so we can start at the first one. Okay, so here, and so what I want to create is a very low poly type of vibe, basically. So what I mean with that is just try to create a big world instead of easy parkour. So let's add a part, also add a folder called hobbies, because I like to make things organized. Hobbies, there we go. Let's just make it this first, and let's make it a little bit bigger, especially because this is the first chapter, like that. Now I like to have curved edges, basically. So what we do, we go to model, do 2, boom, duplicate it, control and then D, and then rotate it 90, like this. So you have this kind of 90 degree corner right here. Then let's make it type of color 161, 196, 140. Let's also create a kind of grass color, which is really nice. Let's make it smooth plastic so you don't see the collision between them two. Then I recommend you go to home, the toolbox, I mean, in view, and then go to plugins and go to. But it is actually on the front page, if I'm right. It is called this one, Resize and Gap Fill from Strafe End, or whatever the name is. Really good plugin, really recommend it. So get a plugin and then enable them real quick. There we go. So now they will be, if you go to the plugins, if I'm right, it should be on the top. Then do Gap Fill and just basically fill the gap. There you go. Then you have this nice corner. You can, yeah, so just you have the red one and then the blue one will be there. Do that at each corner. Oh, there we go. So we're finished. okay, now perfect. And then you will see that we have 2 more parts added. Copy them all and lower it 1 stud. There we go. Okay, so now let's make this one bigger. We can actually remove that one, those ones again. So now it should look like this, and then just try to maybe lower it 25, maybe. No, wait, 24, because we no, let's do 19. So at the size, you now see size 28.81. Let's create it to 20. That's perfect. And then make it this color. Go. Let's turn off the shadows. And now again, get your gap fill and boom. Oh no, wrong. Now you have this kind of area, but we wanted to make it even lower. So select all the parts again. I like to group them real quick. Now you do 20 and you copy and paste it, like, let's see, 6 times maybe. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Now I like this effect. I will show you right now. We are gonna make it darker and darker and darker each time we get lower to the ground. And then more lower, we get an even darker color, and then more darker, darker again, so you are almost at black color. Yes, let's remove this one. Now you have this insane cool effect that it gets lower and lower and lower. Maybe you can found clouds, low Poly Cloud. Let's see. Okay, no. Okay. Now you can also do that differently. So just add a part. Let's add it here. Then make it as big as you can make it. It will be this indeed, and then this, and then go. Let's make it the same size as the plates on this one. Make it white, make it smooth plastic. And maybe 0.8. There we go. 20. And then, as you can see, as low as it gets a little bit less visible, basically. Oh, wait, I didn't make this right. There we go. So now you created these type of clouds that will make it look like that you are in the clouds. Okay, this is actually pretty cool already. Now I have models myself that I can maybe give away. Yeah, let me add them real quick. So I got these fences, what I really like. Add them all around. So you actually know where to go. Go. Let's make this. So. Paste them. Yeah, that's actually pretty cool. And then I also got this tree model, which is really cool. Mother. Okay, we're almost finished. I think adding some more type of effects, maybe. Let's think. Maybe some. Well. No, I think actually that's pretty cool. I think. Yeah. So now that you have created your base part, let's add everything in V1. Back them all. Not the clouds. So these are clouds. But that is not a part of V1. And then boom. Let's add a folder. Multiple, and then we just call them all Obi. Obi. And one. Oh. Oh yeah, we can actually do that. Maybe it's easier. Really matter what you call it. And you don't even need to do this, but I'd like to keep things organized, especially for you guys, so you can know more about the way I work. 13, 14. Then group this. Pick to one, and then you can group it again. Okay, so now let's spawn. It will not be ensured. Yep. Okay, so let's ensure it real quick. Go to this folder, to select children and ensure. There we go. Check it out. This looks really cool already. So let's start now with the first obby actually. So of course stage one doesn't need to be hard. So maybe we can actually, is this? Yeah. So maybe we can copy all these, copy paste, group it, make it small. Well, rotate it 45 degrees. There we go. Make it a little bit lower than the wheel. One. And then just add this kind of repeatedly. What I like to do is this, and then try to fit it perfectly in the center of this one. I think that is it, and then just move it. Now it has a perfect aligned piece, basically. Copy and paste it a few times. There we go. And now let's get these ones, and then copy and paste this one where, and add your second one on top of it, and then get the trees again, and let's just add one smaller, so you get a little variety. Your checkpoint. And then, let's see. A little bit more. That looks pretty cool. What else can we add? So wait, let's actually try it real quick. Because this is all now part of the first, but this one needs to be at the second. So let's add this to the second folder. There we go. Okay, so play. Now let's play it. Okay, that is already pretty hard. Okay, no, this is too hard. Right? And the clouds also need to be introduced. I totally forgot about that. What is this? Oh yeah, okay, these ones are dead. Okay. So let's add this also in the first folder. And let's put them closer. Because right now it is way too hard. Go, and then just do a little closer. Yeah, that's good. Okay, let's see. I hope it isn't too hard. No, that is perfect. Okay, so that's already the first checkpoint. Okay, what I also like to do, what I forgot to mention, is go to player and then respawn time to zero. I personally like that, so you get respawned right away, so you don't have to wait every time you fall. Okay, let's paste this here and here. So you get a little bit of variety, and then here. Okay. And then we do one. Okay, so now we created a kind of variety. Let's real quick make folders. This in the fourth one, and this third one. Okay, so now let's add the checkpoints to the plate right here, and this right here. Rotate it, thank you. There we go. Okay, wait, this isn't in the center. Okay. So now we actually have the base. Let's make this a little bit bigger, it looks weird. Okay, so now you can of course have more IDs and more IDs. In this case, I can, for example, add more variation to it. So right now we can, for example, make a, let's think. Maybe a bridge, maybe? Get the part. This will also be the last obby that we will create, because this will be a longer video real quick. Okay, so make it like this. Oh, that is perfect. And then let's make it a kind of sandy kind of color. Oh, now I created it sand. Wait, it needs to be plastic. Paste it to the other side. Okay, so right now let's do this. Let's rotate it 5 each time, or maybe 15. Then this, and then it goes a little bit back more like so, and then eventually it reached the center. Okay, is this kind of the center yet? The weight date, these ones. 45 degrees, I mean 180. Oh no, wait, never mind. Let's back. Now you actually have this kind of bridge vibe. Okay, now again, go to plugins, go to cap fill. Boom, boom. Okay, wait, that isn't the right size. There we go. And just do this. It's this kind of U form. Pretty cool. Oh, there we go. Now we have created this kind of bridge vibe. Now, of course, you are not allowed to walk on these lines. Select them all, like so, and select all the wedges that it created for us. Hit real quick and select all the and short, of course, and then you can collide it. So you can't walk on these ones because you have to walk on the wood. There we go. Perfect. So let's make it this color. Now, I think a bridge like this doesn't need to look perfect, so place it down randomly. Hope that you can actually complete it. And what I like to do, just because it doesn't look that random, we just create a little bit of variation in the rotation of it. So, there we go. Yeah. Okay, let's try it out. The wood of the bridge wasn't ensured. I keep forgetting that. There we go, and then put it in the second. Oh, nope. Close all these. This in the second one. And ensured. Okay, let's test it out. Oh no, I'm trash. Okay, wait. I actually need to ensure the clouds, of course, because you can now. Okay, let's see. Wait, let's first check if we can actually fall to it. Perfect, and we respawn right away, and now we can just parkour. And boom. Okay, that works perfect. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this today's tutorial of building wise. Let me know in the comments if you actually like this, because I normally don't build, but mostly script and explain. So yeah, let me know, and I wish you have a nice day.